Welcome to Adult YPWW, Lesson 4. I do not own the rights to this music. Today's topic is Understanding Marriage. The lesson text is coming out of Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge. The memory verse, husband, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. And that's Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25. The introduction says, there are five key words in this verse I want to focus on. They are essential to understanding the nature and commitment to marriage. A Christian marriage holds that defining and acting upon these elements are meaningful and vital for creating a good marital relationship. Number one, honorable. Number two, bed. Number three, undefiled. Number four, whoremonger. Number five, marriage. The discussion says, honorable. This word means valuable, costly, highly esteemed, most precious. In the mind and heart of God, marriage is a precious and valued institution. Without it, God could not fulfill his eternal purpose in the earth. This is why God takes marriage very serious. Marriage is God's idea. If we are to succeed in it, we must treat it as if it were precious. Bed. This word literally means couch of conception. The Latin word is coitus, which is the sexual union of male and female. The bed of marriage is the only place that God permits a man and woman, husband and wife, to unite sexually. Undefiled. This word literally means without filth or contamination, within the confines of holy matrimony. When two people are true to the marriage vow, there is no filth or corrupting influences, spiritual or otherwise, that can kill, steal, and destroy. Whoremonger. This is a person who associates his or herself with prostitutes, being friends with prostitutes or whores, male or female. It also refers to people who engage in pornography. Pornography is the use of pictures, movies, books, magazines, etc., to sexually arouse oneself. These are people who abuse or misuse sex. God will judge the whoremonger. Marriage. This word literally means the sexual union of husband and wife. It is the sexual union of the mature male and female to bring forth a new individual. By definition, marriage is for male and female unions only. In other words, God never intended homosexual or lesbian unions to ever be. In both the Old and New Testament, homosexuality is condemned. The conclusion says, elements needed for a godly marriage. Covenant relationship with God. Saved spouse who is committed to the things of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 14. And God hath both raised up the Lord and will also raise up us by his own power. Mature character. Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. A man shall leave his father, mother and father. A mature, responsible male is able to get a job, keep a job, and support himself and his family. Union, spiritual and physically. Matthew chapter 19, verse 6. They are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Cleaving. Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. Emotional union. Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Oneness of mind. Amos chapter 3, verse 3. Can two walk together except they be agreed? The questions for today's lesson, and you can search the scriptures on your own. Number one, what are the key words focused on in this lesson? Number two, what are the definitions of each word? Number three, what are the elements needed for a godly marriage? The end. God bless you, and thank you for joining me today.